Welcome, beautiful souls. Today I would like to share with you a transmission, a lovely transmission that came to me when I was connecting telepathically with a cedar race, the Elyan Sukhami. It was all of a sudden. I wasn't expecting it, but it was really an enriching connection and a very wonderful exchange of feelings, thoughts, information. The Elyan Sukhami is a feline race. So let's begin with them. Only very few information is from the book The Cedars written by Elena Danan, but most of it comes from the transmission or the connection, we can say, that he, that being, that feline being, conveyed to me. So let's begin. Now, yes, let's begin. Their galaxy is not yet discovered by Terrans, but by us, because its place is in the Crux constellation, or the Southern Cross constellation, and is placed behind the dark nebula named Colsac Nebula. The Crux constellation is the smallest one in the sky, although it has no formal boundaries. The galaxy where the Elyan Sukhami live is about 600-700 light years from Earth. They are 7D feline humanoids, and they are a precursor race of the Urma and a root race for the Lan. They communicate via vocal, but also telepathically. And now, for them, integrity is very important. He said that they have integrity schools, stressing the word integrity, or the concept, we can say, of integrity, because it doesn't matter if they are children, small children, or adults, but integrity is the first thing they focus on, to maybe we can say to teach, but in reality to help their children to connect with it and live through it. So they also have spiritual temples and schools where they learn about the complexity of the universe, and in this way become walkers of the stars. I really saw them, or perceived them, as walkers of the stars. It was really beautiful. And they wanted to contribute to create a unique human being who could honor himself and all expressions of life. So that's why they contributed to create our own DNA. They know how to use their Merkaba to travel across dimensions using only their consciousness. So they don't need ships to travel. Only when they need to go to some place physically, or in a physical way. They have outposts in North Africa, for example, in Asia, East Russia, and inner Earth. Also in the asteroid belt, in the around the star Merope from the Pleiades, and in the moon Enceladus that is in Saturn. They say that cats are a very unique pet species created to be near the humans, and in this way accompany us in our own evolution of consciousness. Cats are also walkers of the stars and can have incredible abilities if we are able to open to it and acknowledge them fully. They also said, or he also said, we are a race that millions of years ago realized that our purpose was to create new races from our original DNA. Although we live in different planets in another galaxy, far away from you, we consider ourselves as multidimensional cosmic beings. Our origins come from our original fathers, the winged felines, also called Ishanwe. The winged felines is a really, really ancient race that comes from the 13th, 14th dimension, together with the Avians, for example, and the Doradians. They are the fathers, mothers, of the original human DNA blueprint. And, well, some days ago I saw the original human DNA blueprint. They showed me it. It was really beautiful. It was a blueprint that it was placed within a sphere. Within a sphere, I saw the different strands, not only the two physical strands, but also 12 more. And in the same way, I saw an opening that allowed for more strands to be added. So, well, it is, because now I also see it. It's really beautiful. Well, so, as I said, their fathers are the winged felines, and he said, we are one of the oldest races of the universe, and we reunite and integrate within us the primordial cosmic feminine and masculine energies with grace and honor. From the necessity of light warriors, the Urma were created, while the Laan that lived in Lyra are a hybrid species with DNA humanoid. Humans don't know what are out there, outside your planet and your solar system. It is not easy to venture out and explore the galaxy. So I encourage you to first fix your problems and become a peaceful civilization. And he stressed peace, to become peaceful, while promoting wisdom and the knowledge of who you are, but also promoting the respect, honoring and taking care of Mother Earth, because she is much more than a planet as you understand it. And then, only then, you would be prepared to be a galactic civilization. learning to walk among the stars requires much honor and integrity, together with courage and boldness. It requires a good connection with your own consciousness and higher self. We have integrated our own higher self within us, within our hearts, so we can say that we are complete beings, although always in constant change and evolution. We are quadrupeds and bipeds, and it is not about the dimension we live as a way to catalog us, but to live with honor and integrity, knowing who we are. Because the universe is much more complex than you think, what you call dimension or densities are really much complex than you think. There's a lot of work to do. Excuse me. And this is the end of the transmission. So I really think that it's a very important one for us, because maybe we are eager to see, to talk with galactic beings, different galactic beings, to see them physically, to shake hands, for example, with the benevolent ones, of course. But now we have many big problems here on Earth among us to resolve. And I agree with this being, with this Elyan Sukhami, because of before coming out of the Earth, coming out of the solar system, is very important to resolve first our own problems. Otherwise, we will become prey of many different agendas. And in this way, the integrity and the purpose of humanity would be lost. So it's very important to begin with ourselves, resolving the problems we have, to become a peaceful civilization, knowing who we are, or at least as much as possible, because there's always more and more to know about ourselves. But at least these are the very foundations to construct a galactic civilization, a really galactic civilization. Think that there are many galactic civilizations that have not an interstellar travel, or they have chosen not to have interstellar travel, but keeping themselves in their own planet or planets, if they have more than one, because they know, already know, what is out there. So if they don't feel prepared, they prefer to stay at home before venturing out and becoming scattered or prey, as I said before, of other agendas, or evidently also malevolent beings, of course. So I feel that it's very important for us to meditate about it, to resolve our problems and become one heart, we can say, as the Hopi prophecy says, become one heart people, and then all together we will be prepared to open up, not only seeing the skies, but walking among them. So that's it for today. Have a lovely day. See you soon.